I'll remind you who I am. My name is Yvan Cadieu. I come from Marseille. I'm from the west of France. I've traveled a lot around the world. I've been cooking in about 15 countries. I've published 15 books. And I came here to present my last book, published in Sweden, about French food, called, how easy to say, Modern France, Une Semaine's Cost. Well, I don't speak Swedish, but I'm very proud to have this book in Sweden, which will be in Finland from September. And I've got two of my own book with my own publication coming sometime at the end of 2011 or the beginning of 2012. Well, anyway, all the weather is great and the sun is there. I thought I'd bring you a little sunshine from Marseille with something we do in France, in the south of France, which are le cake aux olives et aux courgettes. You know what that means? The olive and courgette cake. It sounds like sunshine. It's what we serve for the aperitif, for the end of the day, for the party at lunchtime, or to gather people around a nice glass of wine, or a few bottles of wine, depending how cool your friends are. The first step to make that cake is to put the eggs. I remind you as well that I only use organic ingredients, and I'm going to put 6 eggs, which will make 2 cakes. And so I got my ingredients here at the supermarket before I came. But I'm glad to see that, for example, in the, well, I might as well say it, we're on TV at Sainsbury, the quality of the ingredients is pretty high. Isn't that true? We have the pleasure to have James McIntosh with us, the great chef from UK. Wonderful, look at him. Happy, positive soul.
Yeah.
So I got 6 eggs, and I need to put some yeast as well. One second. I brought the French yeast because I trust my yeast. Yes. But you know, when you travel, you're never sure to find your ingredients. So, once I'm ready to go really fast, normally you only put one little bag, 10 grams. Well, I will go crazy and put 20 grams. Like this, the cake will rise faster. So, 6 eggs, normally 10 grams. Because we want to go fast, I put 20. I'm going to put as well I put this Prosecco Italian, but you use cheap vin champagneisé, you know, made like champagne, which will help the cake to rise. You have to be precise in the way you put it, like I do. Voilà. So now I'm going to mix that together. First, the eggs, the yeast, and the champagne or whatever is...
Yes.
No, because the flavor won't be the same. Yeah. But you could use maybe, you could use like fermented apple juice. You know, an apple juice, which is fizzy.
Yes.
It could be. And lemon as well. Lemon juice helps to ferment.
For the acid.
Yeah, exactly. When I make a sweet cake, I always put lemon juice at the beginning. And grated lemon. I could have done so this morning. Voilà. Now I'm going to put some of my spices as well. So I'm going to put some grated orange zest. My spices are all organic. I use some garlic powder as well, from France, that's my brand, called Cook. And what I like about this organic powdered garlic, it tastes a little like roasted. It's very interesting flavor. I put like one big teaspoon. In France, we love garlic. Yeah. Well, if you have all garlic, everybody eats garlic, then you're fine together. Unless you think you're going to have a special party late at night, that's different. All right, I put some origan, you know, which is very typical from the south of France. Dried oregano. Mmm, I love that smell. Voilà. And I'm going to put as well a little touch of vanilla. I put a lot of spices in my food. I remind you that spices doesn't mean hot. It means only a lot of flavor. I see Mediterranean people there, you know what it means, you know. Give some life, excite the buds, you know, give some happiness to your mouth. Oh yes, brothers and sisters, give happiness to your food, because that's what it's all about. It doesn't matter really what you do on the table. What counts is who are the people around the table. Yes, the Lord of good food sent me there to pass me and to pass you that message of good food.
here.
You believe in that?
Yeah, we're here.
Oh yes, brothers and sisters, because what counts is that we are all part of the same world. The passion of cooking, the passion of sharing, the passion of giving. Oh yes, that's what food is all about. A book is
Hallelujah.
Only
Hallelujah.
Oh, yes. The book is only necessary. Let's get back to quiet and simple cooking. Yes. I've got this moment of madness sometimes. Oh yes, but I get back to real things. I'm going to put now some little pepper. By the way, I remind you as well that you might not know, but I grew up in the west of France, in Brittany, in Bretagne. We are the same with the Scots, the Irish, the people from Galicia as well. We all originate from Central Asia. And it's true, you know, so we all have the same base culture. Even if it comes from many thousands of years ago, we'll all have this passion for our own culture. La Bretagne, les pays celtes. Voilà. But anyway, I decided to go to the south of France to get some sunshine because it rains too much in Brittany. Right, all my spices are there. I put as well a little paste of colombo. You know what colombo is? Colombo is the paste of curry from the French West Indies. All right, you have many types of combination of curries, but that one is my favorite because it originates from where I come from. I'll have a little spoon, my friend, and I'll put a little spoon of that. And you could replace the salt by soy sauce, you know, to give it a little more body. And you could put as well a few drops of sesame oil, which I do as well sometimes. I'm going to use a little bit of that beautiful salt from the Pays de Galles, from Wales. A Frenchman who is using salt from Wales, that's not a common thing, but I will do today. Voilà. A little touch there. Hop là. And I'm going to add as well my olive oil. And that's going to be the gourmand part of that cake, generously. And I've got my organic flour. In France, we have flour for pastry, and flour for cakes, and flour for bread. Thank you very much. I put, it's too big. You won't get it. Why use that? Anyway. Here you are. A little spoon of that paste. You could use paste of curry instead of colombo. Voila. And now I'm going to put my flour. As you can see, it's pretty precise. Tell me when to stop. It's about 600 grams. Voila. That's it. I'm so expert on the weight with my hand, I don't need a scale. And now I start mixing this. Could you put the heat on for me, that frying pan? And actually, you know what you can do for me? You can start peeling one or two shallots. Here you are, with a little knife. My assistant from Korea, who just graduated from the Cordon Bleu school, which we must thank because Cordon Bleu is one of the best schools in the world. Yeah, man! Right. So now, you see, what counts is to have something that is moist, but not too much. Voilà. A little like a chewing gum in some aspect. See, that's a little too, a bit more wine would be great. A bit more olive oil. Voilà. That's it. Thank you. And I'm going to do a little courgette as well. Is the heat on at the maximum? Oh, you can put very high. That's it. When my hand sticks, it's ready. Voilà. Up. See that cake, the texture is just right now. You see what it looks like? Not, and don't work it out too much, otherwise it's going to be very, how do you say, twingy? I don't know the word in English. Sorry?
Elastic.
Elastic! Oh yes, elastic. Sister, thanks to you. You follow the recipe with great heart, I can see that. Yes, yes, yes. Voilà, so the pastry is there. I will check the seasoning. Did I put some pepper? Well, I could put more. Pepper is sexy. Oh, hey, a little, no, come on, hey, little thing I tell you. If you want to feel, it's a word in English that starts with H. H-O-R-N-Y. Horny! You can have that in cooking as well, yeah. You put 5 little grains of black pepper in your mouth with 4 almond cloves. Well, you can go one by one, and the almonds there. 4 almonds, 4 peppers, and a little glass of milk. You chew all that, have a glass of milk, and then after you go and say hi to your close friend. You know, after the meal or for a starter. Well, you could have other things with it, salads and stuff like this, but you start with that, with a little glass of wine, then you're going to feel like hopping about like a frog. Yeah, man, like us in France, you know. Even if we're a little arrogant, we've got that little passion for sharing love with food. Anyway, I'm going to now take my French knife. Yeah, man, that's the way we do in France. This is my traveling happy knife. Yes. No, I'm only joking. Anyway, I'm going to do a little courgette. We could put a little olive oil in the pan. Thanks. Could you peel a few shallots for me? How many did you do? Oh, great. I couldn't do another one. Thanks a lot. Sorry about this. Voila. Organic courgettes. The olive oil in the pan there. We're going to put a little dash of that. Alors, once I've got organic, I don't take off the skin. All right? Because there are many good nutrients and vitamins in that skin. You see? I'm going to do dices. Voila. By the way, do you know what it means, voila? Well, we say every two words in France. It means that's it. Voila. All right, dice of courgettes. And the courgettes, I want them very, very hot. I can smell the pan is almost burning. This is what I like. That's it. That's the way. Start with the first courgettes.